I see nobody quick to help. I'm the one to make the plays. Handle the rockets at the pick myself. I'm the one that's always up late night. They were in the back. What is going on, guys? It's your boy Emrez, and today is Zerd Day, so I'm gonna be showing you where he is. So what you want to do is you want to spawn right here as always, and you want to head to the left. He is located down to the left by the big doors that nobody knows what is behind, but that is a different story. Anyways, this week I think some people will be happy, like exotic collectors as well as warlocks, if you don't have this helmet by now. So let's look at this weird motherfucker. And this week he has the MK44 Stanisides for the Titan class. Now I do not recommend these boots. I'd say pretty low stat roll, don't really know, don't care too much about them, don't like them. They only increase the duration of shoulder charge. It's not that good. I wouldn't buy it unless you need boots to be 32. Obviously there's always an unless to any of these, unless you need something. Now the Mask of the Third Man, he is selling that for the hunters, but let's see, he's also selling for the upgrade. So if you have the old version, I would just honestly, I don't know if you should upgrade or buy these, because the upgrade's only 4 more. I guess if you really want to upgrade it, if not, just buy it straight up. It's a good helmet, amazing helmet. I use it for Crow to Hard and Normal on my Hunter, so the intellect's pretty low. Other than that, it's a pretty good helmet. And then the Apotheosis Veil for the Warlocks. The discipline is lower than what I have right now, but still pretty good. I'm pretty sure he sold this helmet before, or maybe not, but it's a great helmet again for Crow to Hard or anything like that. It's pretty good. I would buy it if I was a warlock and an exotic collector. And then for the weapon, we have the Hard Light. Now I don't believe he's ever actually sold this, so this is great for exotic collectors and people who want the Hard Light. I would buy this, but I already have it, so there's no point. Then, as always, he has the exotic shard, and this week he has the exotic helm engram. Now, I don't have any modes of light because I used it all on Iron Banner, and it was bad. Let's just say it was bad. I might upload that and tell you why it was bad. Again, we're back to the Master of the Third Man, 104 intellect, not that high. I would just pass on it unless you really need it. Lucky Raspberry. Pretty good intellect roll. I think I have a 161, so this is kind of medium. I don't like the chest piece. Wouldn't buy it. Wouldn't recommend. Then we have the Skull Fort for the Titans. Really low discipline roll. Would not upgrade it. The Crest of Alpha Loopy. I always say chest. That's a high intellect roll. I would upgrade these. This is amazing. Like, amazing for intellect, but not so much in certain situations. This is more for, I guess, 3v3s and stuff to revive teammates faster. Or strikes, I guess, if you're really into that. And then he has the upgrade for the Skull of Dire Ahamkara for the Warlocks. Again, a low intellect roll. Pretty good helmet. Let's see if that's a higher intellect than mine. It is by 1. So I'm not going to upgrade it just because it's by 1. It's a lot of work. And as you can see, I don't have any glimmer. Now, another upgrade is for the Warlocks. The Heart of Praxic Fire, a discipline of 114 out of 122. Let's just equip that. Let's see, mine's a 132. So if you have the old version, upgrade it. Unless your intellect's better, then I would still upgrade it. I don't know how many times he actually has this for upgrade. Now, wow, I just said now a lot. he has the Hard Light for an upgrade. I would buy the Hard Light rather than upgrade it. It costs less. I always say this. Red Death, I would definitely upgrade it if you didn't buy it last week, which I'm pretty sure everybody did. Invective, now if you're a long time user of it, upgrade it. Other than that, just wait. I would most likely wait. Patience and Time, not my favorite sniper rifle. Good for arc burns. Don't use it much though, so I would say don't upgrade it, but then again, everything is up to you. Galahorn, if you still have the old version, upgrade, main priority right here. And then the Truth, a great Crucible Rocket. I would upgrade, but I already have two with the new ones, so there's really no point. But it's a great Crucible rocket if you play Crucible. Now, down here he has pulse rifle telemetries, scout rifle telemetries, machine gun telemetries, plasma drive, emerald coil, and heavy ammo. So if you're running low on heavy ammo, I would buy it. I think I am a little bit, not too much though, so I'm gonna just buy a couple right here. But I think that will be it for this week, sir. Overall, not bad. Apotheosis Veil and Hardlar are the two main things here. So, you know, Warlocks aren't getting jacked. You know what I mean? Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I'll see you guys next time.